On behalf of the University, I'm delighted to welcome you here to the Barony Hall for this congregation for the conferment of degrees. It's pleasing to see so many people in the hall from near and from far. Today's a very special day in our university calendar. It is a graduation day, which makes it a day of celebration, but it's also a double celebration because this week is the first time that we've been able to hold graduation ceremonies since the coronavirus pandemic. And it's great to be back in this graduating hall and to see the wonderful achievements of our soon-to-be graduates. Now, in a few moments, it will be my privilege to cap each of our graduates as their name is called out and they come up on stage to receive their award. Our graduates will stand before me and I shall lift the graduation cap above their head to symbolise the conferment of graduation. Thereafter, they will collect their parchments and return to their seats. The capping tradition, it has its roots in ancient China, and it's recognised as a rite of passage and as a mark of achievement. And for each of our graduates once capped, this also signifies that they're now part of a community of scholars at the University of Strathclyde, which can stretch back over 200 years to the Scottish Enlightenment. At the close of graduation, we have a reception in our nearby learning and teaching building, which has been newly opened. Everyone is invited to come along for celebrations and refreshments. We also hope to have an academic procession from here to the learning and teaching building. It will very much depend upon the weather. I think it is due to rain later this morning, but we'll keep our fingers crossed that we can have the ceremony and process to the learning and teaching building with the rain staying off. But I'll get an update on that towards the end of this morning's proceedings. In the meantime, I do hope that you enjoy the ceremony, and to all our visitors, when you see your loved ones come up on stage to receive their award, please feel free to celebrate. Cheer, clap, stamp your feet. These occasions do not come down very often, and we have to make the most of it. I now formally declare that this congregation for the conferment of degrees is open, and I invite Dr. Kepa Mandible, the Associate Dean of the Faculty of Engineering, to present our graduates to receive their awards. Thank you.
Vice Principal, in the name of the University and by the authority of Senate, I present to you this student. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy for research in the Department of Electronic and Electrical Engineering, Kieran Gilbert. Bartosz Soltowski. Monchil Vasilev. For the degree of Master of Science in Supply Chain and Logistics Management, Nadia Said Masood Albadoui. Shripad Gopal Orangi. Asim Arjunan. Prasad Sunil Gaure. Ross Archibald Kennedy. Argiro Kepeno. Murali Manoj Kota. Muhammad Danish Liu. Prakash Murugesan. Cindy Diniharsiani Yam. In Supply Chain and Procurement Management,
Robert Gordon Gore. Charles Richard Kennedy. Craig James Martin. Jack McVeigh. Bob Kersefiani. Richard Stephen Walton. Fraser Wines. In supply chain and sustainability management, Hannah Rabea Feistauer. Shaver Undeutsch. In 5G advanced communications, George Nairn. In autonomous robotic intelligence systems, Quivin Callinan. Stavros Stavroglou. In electrical power and energy systems, Anish Chandran. Felix Merck. Fyodor Mikhalchia Simoyu. In electronic and electrical engineering, Frank Ibong Ibong. Linghai Gao. Majid Kamandina. Mark Mathers. Muhammad Owais Malik. Maxwell Fraser McAllister. Tianxiao Tang. Michael Wells. In machine learning and deep learning, Khalid Omer Mohammed. Ross Perry. Yilan Xiao. In wind energy systems, Daniel James Harper. Michael Harkus Watt. For the degree of Master of Engineering in Product Design Engineering, William Alexander John Bramfitt. For the degree of Bachelor of Engineering in Product Design Engineering, Kiram James Duffy. Daniel Conlon Morris. in Sports Engineering, Kim Mulder. In Supply Chain and Logistics Management, Ramesh Dhawan. For the degree of MSc in Systems Engineering Management, Ashwet Ashok Malwankar.
Ladies and gentlemen, colleagues, and most of all, Strathclyde University's newest graduates, it is my pleasure to once again welcome you to our graduation ceremony here in the Barney Hall. Quite right, our graduates have been centre stage, and I would like to begin my address by congratulating all of you once again on your achievements. Your hard work has paid off, and you've now graduated in front of your families, friends, and the staff who taught and supported you during your time at the university. Very well done, and let's everyone give our graduates a resounding round of applause. Now, in a short while, at the close of graduation, you may be asked to join the academic procession as this leaves the Barony Hall, depending upon the weather. This invitation actually symbolises the fact that you're no longer students. You're full members of the academic community of Strathclyde, a worldwide community that numbers over 180,000 individuals. You now join such esteemed company as David Livingston, the missionary and explorer, John Logie Baird, who invented television, Dame Eilish Angelini, Scotland's first female Solicitor General and Lord Advocate, Helen Liddell and Baroness Annabel Goldie, leading Scottish politicians, and the entrepreneur and philanthropist Sir Tom Hunter. Today, we are celebrating our first in-person graduation ceremony since the beginning of the coronavirus pandemic, and we know that this had a far-reaching and unprecedented impact on all of our lives. The pandemic has challenged our health systems, it has impacted on our economies, and it has changed the way in which we work and the way in which we study. However, it has also demonstrated what society can achieve when we work together. It's placed science at the forefront of finding the solutions to the challenges we face. It was science and universities that delivered vaccines for the COVID-19 virus in record time. And it is science, engineering, and education that will help us address other pressing issues, such as climate change. Earlier this month, Glasgow hosted COP26, the summit of world leaders which came together to agree measures to minimise global warming and climate change. As a university, we are very aware of our responsibilities to reducing our impact on the planet, which is why we set a target to reduce our carbon emissions by 70% by 2025 and to reach net zero before 2040. COP26 also saw former US President Barack Obama visit Strathclyde University to speak with our students about the important role that young people will play in tackling climate change. The former president had a very simple but powerful message for those who had gathered outside our new learning and teaching building. Pausing on the steps, he said to everyone to get active. Now, to our graduates, in reaching this point today, each of you will have benefited from the active support of your families, friends, and supporters, and academically through your lecturers, tutors, and supervisors. Many are celebrating here today because you carry with you their hopes and their wishes and their confidence for a successful career. For the past 15 minutes or so, their applause has rung in your ears as you each in turn across this stage to receive your awards. I would now like to invite our graduates to show their appreciation for all of the support that they have received from their family, friends, and supporters. Our graduates' success, and in turn our success as a university, is in no small part due to the efforts of our staff who are delivering our vision as a leading international technological university that is socially progressive. And you can tell a lot about the values of an organisation simply by looking at its roots. Strathclyde University traces its lineage back to 1796, when Anderson brought it into being, the only Scottish university founded during the Age of Enlightenment and embodying the Enlightenment principles of reason, tolerance, and equality. Anderson's belief in useful learning and his commitment to taking knowledge and using this for the greater good is the motivating force which gives Strathclyde University its momentum today. Anderson believed in knowledge for the greater good and education for all, what we would call widening access and participation. Strathclyde University is at the forefront of widening access to higher education by welcoming those with the ability to learn regardless of their personal circumstances. And 20% of our new students each year come from the most challenging areas of the country. Our ethos of useful learning continues to be relevant today as we seek new knowledge that we can readily apply to the challenges. We are a research-intensive university, determined to make a positive difference to the lives of our students, to society, and to the world. Through our groundbreaking research, we are helping to change the world for the better. Through our scientists and engineers, we are leading the development of innovative technologies that will facilitate the transition from fossil fuels to clean, sustainable energy sources, such as wind, solar, geothermal, and hydrogen. We are developing new drugs along with new manufacturing processes that will provide cheaper, more effective treatments in the fight against cancer, kidney disease and inflammatory disease, whilst also supporting our health services to face the challenges of health and social care and the changing demographics of the 21st century. Through our focus on entrepreneurial education, we are helping our students and staff to create new, sustainable businesses as well as supporting economic growth. We are also revitalising this part of the city through the Glasgow City Innovation District, attracting companies to work with the university in health technologies, financial technologies, 5G communications, industrial informatics, and space and quantum applications, much of which is based within our own technology and innovation centre. We are growing Scotland's manufacturing capabilities and the Advanced Manufacturing Innovation District Scotland out at Glasgow Airport, where the National Manufacturing Institute Scotland facility is hosted by Strathclyde and is under construction. Our globally minded students and staff are also making a difference in sustainable development and helping to address some of the inequalities in India, Malawi, and the Gambia by establishing clean water supplies, renewable power sources, and healthcare facilities. We understand the value of working in partnership as we extend our global reach with other leading universities, including Stanford, New York University, MIT, Caltech, Tsinghua, and the National University of Singapore. As a university, we are continually working to enhance our student experience, investing in our campus, as evidenced by our new sports building and our new learning and teaching buildings. And we are investing in mental health and well-being support, placing our students at the heart of everything that we do. Our progress in these areas has been recognised in recent years, and we're the only UK university to win Times Higher Education University of the Year twice, having won the accolade again in 2019. In recent times, we've also been named Business School of the Year, Workplace of the Year, and Research Project of the Year. And earlier this year, the Times Higher placed Strathclyde University fourth in the UK for student satisfaction out of 150 institutions. In terms of some of our staff and student successes, Professor Gareth Pearce of Electronic and Electrical Engineering, he has been awarded the Royal Academy of Engineering Research Chair to support his research in in-process non-destructive testing and composites. Design, Manufacture and Engineering Management student Craig Fingland is a recipient of the Prince Philip Prize awarded by the Hammermen of Glasgow. Finlay Harris, a student in the Department of Electronic and Electrical Engineering, is one of the 12 inaugural recipients of the Amazon Future Engineering Bursaries, which are allocated in partnership with the Royal Academy of Engineering. Design, Manufacturing and Engineering Management PhD student Andrew Stewart has won the USEPSON's 2021 Talent Programme, an international competition to identify exceptional students with the potential to become future leaders in the field of precision engineering and nanotechnology. And Professor Stephen MacArthur of Electronic and Electrical Engineering has won the prestigious 2021 IEEE Richmond Kaufman Award for outstanding contributions in industrial systems engineering. Now, these are just some of the many contributions that have been made by our students and by our staff. And Strathclyde has been increasingly recognised as a place where things happen, and this is why our graduates are so highly prized by companies and organisations that are looking to recruit the best talent to drive their businesses forward. Our success is in no small part due to the collective efforts, talent and commitment of our staff, the 4,000 colleagues who deliver our vision as a leading international technological university. And like me, they are very proud of your achievements today. All of our students learn how to be innovative, enterprising and creative, and they can make a real difference when they go out into the workplace. So wherever your career takes you, always remember that as a Strathclyde graduate, useful learning carries with it responsibilities that go beyond academic scholarship. And finally, let me offer my congratulations to you all once again on your achievements, and I hope that you enjoy the remainder of what is a special day. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, that now concludes the formal part of this morning's graduation ceremony, which I hope you have enjoyed. I would remind you that we have a reception in a nearby learning and teaching building, which everyone is invited to come along. And I've been given the thumbs up from the back of the hall, which means that the weather has stayed just good enough that we can actually have a procession from the Barney to the learning and teaching building. And I'll take this opportunity to invite Strathclyde University's newest graduates to join the academic procession. So ladies and gentlemen, once we process out of the building, if you could remain in the hall until we do so, and then immediately follow us over to the learning and teaching building, and we shall see you there for some refreshments. I now formally declare that this congregation for the conferment of degrees is closed.